Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. As many of you know, I love being a student. Not everybody agrees with me on that. Wayne, I know you don't. I really love the whole like reading and writing and dialoguing with classmates and professors. And it's just something that I will, I think, always enjoy. And throughout my educational career, I have been at several different institutions that have all sort of left their mark on me. And where I am going now is no different. Now, I don't get to scare any of you, because I'm going to an ELCA seminary to do some more graduate study. But it's a good thing. It's good to be challenged. It's good to discuss and dialogue and really get at the heart of the matter. And while I'm doing this on an ELCA campus, I have to be cognizant of something. See, a little while ago, they sent out a roster of all the students to everybody so you knew who your classmates were. And sure enough, they had your name, your program, and your denomination. And wouldn't you know it, I'm the only person from the LCMS on the rolls. I didn't expect there to be other Missouri Synod students, but this means something for me. It means that when I'm there, I'm kind of an ambassador for the LCMS. There is no tougher fight than that between brothers and sisters. And I think the ELCA and the LCMS have had this sort of real bitter argument toward each other since at least the ELCA has been around, but certainly longer before that in the different iterations. I take this very seriously, that when I walk on that campus and dialogue with professors and students, I may not have been the first LCMS person they meet, and I probably won't be the last, but I can control sort of how I respond so that I don't contribute to the bad blood that exists. Being an ambassador in that sense, it really weighs on me, because I don't want to misstep. I don't want to make things worse. Now, that doesn't mean I sort of hide back from what I think is true in the classroom setting, but it means I take it seriously. And I think all of us sort of understand that when we go out to places, whether that's to our work or out to places with friends, we are sort of representing something else, whether it's our family. If we're at a conference, sometimes we're representing a company. We've felt this, we've seen this before, the weight and the need of being good ambassadors in the places we find ourselves. And our text this morning, which is not actually from Romans, that was my bad, it's from 2 Corinthians. Paul is talking about being ambassadors. And if you know anything about Paul and the church in Corinth, it's that the church in Corinth needs to be reminded who it is. Like, it needs to be reminded of its identity, sort of over and over again. 1 Corinthians is a veritable what not to do manual for the church, because they don't really get what's going on. And if you want to learn a little more about 1 Corinthians, I'm going to use this as a commercial to plug Sunday school, where we're going through it. We've still got a good 5 chapters left, and that'll probably take us another 2 years. So, come for that. But Paul, when he is writing to the church in Corinth, is really trying to remind them always who they are in Christ and what difference that makes. And the epistle this morning is no different. Paul comes out and is very clear. He's very open. Anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. Behold, the old has passed, the new has come. That means that for those people in Corinth, and for you and I today, we have been baptized into Christ. It means we are a new thing. It means that what Christ has done for you and for me on the cross has actually made a difference. Whether we feel that or not, whether we can explain that or not, Christ's death and resurrection has actually changed us. It has given us a different identity. And the question is, what does that mean as we sort of go about our lives? And in this case, Paul is trying to get people to realize that wherever you go, you are an ambassador for Christ. God making his appeal through us. Now that's not something to sort of take lightly. God has chosen each person in this room to be an ambassador for his son, to be for the world a witness to what Christ did, to how he lived, but more importantly, to his death and resurrection. And sometimes we can forget about that. Sometimes that's just too much to take onto our shoulders because we just have too much going on in life. I get it. There are always errands to run. There is always some kid that needs to be picked up and driven somewhere. There is always something else going on. And usually more things get piled on in just sort of the worst time. There has been a lot going on this weekend in the life of Holly and myself. Not the least of which is my son has decided not to sleep through the night, the last like 4 nights. And so that's been rough, rougher on Holly to be sure than me. But then in the midst of all of that, I get the news that my great aunt passed away. And my great aunt Marion she mattered a lot. When we were homeless, we were staying with her. And she has always, and her husband have always been a source of support. And to sort of get that news in the midst of everything that's going on, it's just like one more thing I can't handle right now. And of course it would happen during Lent, because Lent is the busiest time. 2 services, we've got a church council meeting this week, I've got confirmation. I mean, it's just like everything is hitting at the right, perfect storm type moment, which is really the worst time it could happen. And so I get that it can be very difficult to remember that when we walk out the door, there's another hat we got to worry about putting on. But the reality of it is, whether we realize it or not, we are always giving witness to who Christ is. The question is not if you are witnessing to who Christ is, it's what you are witnessing. Now, those of us who come here for strength and support, who understand the words of the hymn we just sung, not intellectually, but in an emotional way, we get that we have a support structure here. We get that when times are tough, the people on our left and on our right are the people we can rely on. And that's true for everybody in this room. The question is, how do people outside this room handle those moments? When life just gets rougher and rougher and doesn't seem to be letting up. Because the fact of the matter is, they are our responsibility too. Christ doesn't just die for people in this room, but for those outside of it. And that is a burden that God places on all of us. Because everybody on this earth matters to God. We like them or not. We talked about this on Wednesday at the midweek service. That each and every person you see is someone whom Christ died for. And you and I are supposed to be ambassadors to them. Because God is making his appeal through us. And the only reason why we can do that, the only reason why we can demonstrate who Christ is because we've received him. Because we've been baptized into him. Because we fed on his very body and blood. We have heard his promises preached. And we have had that faith created and sustained in us. And sometimes the only thing we can do is like roll out of bed in the morning. Because life is hard even for us. But life being hard for us is not an excuse not to engage the world. We're always engaging the world. The question is whether or not we're being those ambassadors for Christ, whether we are recognizing that God is making his appeal through us. And that is what Paul is driving home here in this epistle lesson. Paul's not letting anybody off the hook because God made him who knew no sin to be sin for us and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. It's not one more thing to add onto your plate. It's actually part of what it means to be in Christ. I know that's hard, and I know that's not what you want to hear. It's not necessarily what I want to hear this morning. I don't want to hear that there's one other thing I have to worry about. But that doesn't make it any less true. Because while I know I have a support structure made up of people in this room, people outside these walls might not know that. And it's up to us, as ambassadors for Christ, to make Christ's love known. And we can do that. We have strength for that because of what Christ has done for us on the cross and through the empty tomb. It's not empty words. It has actually changed you, like I said earlier. Anyone who has been baptized into Christ is a new creation. The old is gone. Behold,